Good day viewers and welcome to the Polymer Update Daily News Show. This is Preksha Potra from the Polymer Update Mumbai office. Today's special newsreel is sponsored by Ahmedabad-based Yogeshwar Engineering, the Pakistan Plastics Manufacturers Association and Bhavnagar-based Vijay Mechanical. Ahmedabad-based Yogeshwar Engineering is a reputed manufacturer and supplier of premium quality range of belt conveyors, screw conveyors, PET floating tanks, PET crystallizers, PP floating tanks, air blowers, PET washing lines, PET washing plants, cyclone dust collectors, PET grinding machines, plastic dryer machines, pre-washing machines, washing plant control panels, etc. The company invites all to visit their stall number H6D4, hall number 6 at Plast India 2018, to be held at Gandhinagar, Ahmedabad, Gujarat from February 7th to 12th, 2018. Bhavnagar-based Vijay Mechanical is a manufacturer and exporter of a wide range of qualitative and durable ring doubler machines and spares, heavy-duty doubler machines, ring twister machines, etc. The company invites all to visit their stall number H14D34, hall number 14 at Plast India 2018, to be held at Gandhinagar, Ahmedabad, Gujarat from February 7th to 12th, 2018. The Pakistan Plastics Manufacturers Association, organizer of PAK Plast 2018 exhibition, to be held in Lahore from March 16 to 18, 2018, a leading international trade fair dedicated towards plastic machinery, components, raw materials and chemicals. In polypropylene market update, demand and pricing trends remain steady in China. In Southeast Asia, PP prices are likely to move upward owing to improved buying sentiments and higher import offers from overseas producers. PP prices in Far East Asia are expected to remain stable, while in Southeast Asia, prices may rise by US$10 per metric ton today. In India, Aramco Saudi Arabia has concluded deals for PP raffia and PP injection grades at US$1300 per metric ton levels for end February or early March 2018 shipment on a CIF Nhava Sheva port basis. In polyethylene market update, in the Far East and Southeast Asian markets, the buying trends were upbeat in HDPE on account of firmer import offers from overseas supplier in the region. HDPE prices may rise by US$10 to 20 per metric ton in the Far East and Southeast Asian region. LLDPE and LDPE prices are expected to remain stable in Far East and Southeast Asia. In polyvinyl chloride market update, in China and Southeast Asia, PVC prices are likely to rise sharply on the back of firmer import offers and deals concluded at higher price levels in the region. Prices of PVC in China and Southeast Asia are expected to gain by US$40 to 50 per metric ton today. In India, Formosa, Taiwan has concluded large deals for PVC resin suspension grade at US$10.20 per metric ton levels for shipment in March 2018 on a CIF Nhava Sheva port basis. In domestic market updates, most market players are of the opinion that PE, PP and PVC prices are likely to be left unchanged by local producers today. The Maharashtra State Environment Department has proposed to ban the production, use, storage, distribution and sale of plastic items, citing their adverse impact on the environment, effective from 1st March 2018. Polymer Update spoke with Mr. Jagdish Tanna, founder and director of Leela Polymers Private Limited, and asked him to share his opinion regarding the ban.
Not at all. It is a question of how we have the collection systems in our country, and on that basis the whole ruckus has been created because we do not have a right collection system. That is the reason. The solution to ban plastic is not at all the solution for the industry. There is no alternative to plastics. Today, without plastic, from the day in the morning till the time when you wake up till the night, you are using plastics. And the ban would unnecessarily increase the usage of the plastic in illegitimate ways, and illegally the trade will increase because there is no substitute for plastic and all are very expensive. We already experienced Karnataka, who banned the plastic usage in the for takeaway food. They had a huge loss in that state. All restaurant owners had even approached to the governments, and there was no alternative for those plastic cups where they carry sambars, those plastic bags where they carry chutney. There is no solution. There is no alternate solution wherein a plastic, other substance like paper, other substance like textile, there is no other solution to this. It is because of we do not have the mechanism to collect the waste in the all cities across India. If we develop a mechanism to collect properly the waste, plastic is the superb material in the world. Today, India is exporting huge quantity of plastic bags which are thin, 8 microns, in USA, in Europe, in developed nations where the collection systems are organized. It is here in India, we do not have the collection system. That is the reason we are seeing the problems. First of all, self-realization is must. If we use and throw the plastic bags or cups or anything, that itself is harming the environment, the choking of the gutters. This negativity comes from the hype which is created by the media about the ban on the plastics. Our own perception first has to change. Then the collection system automatically has to be taken place, and then automatically that negative perception will go away.
If you have enjoyed watching this daily news video from Polymer Update and have found it to be useful for your business, please subscribe to our channel by pressing the button below. It's Wednesday, 7th February 2018. This is Preksha Bothra. Thank you. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/polymerupdate and be sure to click the like button. You may also find us on Twitter at @PolymerUpdate. For the latest news from the plastics and petrochemicals industry, subscribe to our YouTube channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon.